Hi friends, in this session we are mainly concentrating on insertion sort mechanism. Well, in previous sessions we are already discussing about bubble sort as well as selection sort mechanisms, right? So in this session we are mainly concentrating on insertion sort. So here, what is the algorithm for insertion sort? Then we are taking one example, solve this example based on this algorithm. Then I am writing a program for insertion sort using C language. Then we are analyzing the time complexity for insertion sort for best case, average case, worst case, right? So we are discussing one by one. So first of all, I am writing the algorithm for insertion sort. So we know very well about algorithm. So algorithm is a step by step process for solving any problem. So here I am writing the algorithm for insertion sort, algorithm for insertion sort. So for each and every algorithm, I am writing four major elements: what is input, what is output, and what is data structure, and what are the steps, right? So here I am writing the input. For each and every sorting mechanism, input is unsorted array of elements, right? So here I am writing input and unordered array of elements. Then I am writing output. We are taking unordered array of elements. By applying insertion sort mechanism, this unordered array is arranged into ordered array of elements, right? So that is our output. Here, it is our output, ordered array of elements. Ordered array of elements. Data structure is our each and every sorting mechanism. We are using common data structure, that is arrays, fine. So that's why here I am writing linear data structure array. Linear data structure array, fine. So then I am writing the steps for solving insertion sort problem, right? So here I am taking a looping mechanism. So here first step is for I equal to 1 to n. 1 to n. Then we are set temp is equal to E of I. Temp is equal to E of I. Then set j is equal to I. Again, we are checking one more condition, y j greater than 0. J greater than 0, logical end of E of j minus 1 greater than 10. J minus 1 greater than 10, right? So here, once this condition becomes true, set E of j is equal to E of j minus 1. Then also set j is equal to j minus 1. So after completion of this step, we are closing the while loop. End of while loop. Then temp is set to be E of j. Finally, we are closing the I for loop also, right? So here, end of I do. So finally I am writing stop. Finally I am writing stop. So this is the simple, this is simple algorithm to solve the sorting problem, right? So these are the simple steps for insertion sort mechanism. And one more thing here, E of j is equal to 10. E of j is equal to 10, right? So based on these steps, I'm taking one example. That example can be solved with the help of these steps, right? So here I am taking one example. A best example, best real-time example for insertion sort is playing cards. Playing cards are the best example. But suppose if you have to insert any card, that card is compared to the previous elements. So once we can find out the less element, then pick the card. Ultimately, we are swapping all the cards to the next position, right? So that is the best example for insertion sort, right? So here I am writing the example for insertion sort. So before solving example, I am writing logic. I am writing the logic with the help of C language, right? So here I am writing the logic for insertion sort mechanism. So first of all, I am taking loop na for I loop starts from I is equal to 1, I less than n, I plus plus. Fine. Then this condition becomes true. We are set temp is equal to E of I. Temp is equal to E of I. Then j value is set to be I. Again we are checking one more condition. While j greater than 0, logical end of E of j minus 1 greater than temp. So both are true, it will return true. This is the logical end symbol. So logical end, both are true, it will return true, otherwise it will return false, right? So both are true, it will return true, then only we can execute the remaining procedure in while loop, right? So what is the procedure for while loop? So here, so once this condition becomes true, E of j is said to be E of j minus 1, then j is equal to j minus 1. Fine. So this is the closing of while loop, right? So then I am writing E of, E of j is equal to 10. Finally, I am closing the I loop parts, right? So this is the simple C logic. So based on this C logic, I'm solving one example. So here I am taking, our example is n is equal to 4. N is equal to 4. So here I am taking one array. So which contains 4 elements. So first suppose I am taking 6, 2, 7, 1. Our index is starts from 0, 1, 2, 3. So these are the indexes, these are the values. Remember that one, right? So here I am taking this example. So based on this logic, I am solving this example. So what is our ultimate aim? To arrange all the elements in the ascending order, right? So what is the first condition? I is equal to 1. Then we are checking the condition. 1 less than n value, 4. Condition is true, right? So once this condition becomes true, then we are executing these statements. Temp is equal to E of I. What is E of I? E of 1. E of 1 is equal to, what is E of 1? 2. Now temp value becomes 2. Temp is equal to 2. Fine. Then j value is said to be I. What is I value? 1. So after completion of these two, we are checking the condition. What is the operation? Logical end. Both are true, it will return true. Then only execute these statements. Otherwise, we are not executing these statements. Any one of the false, it will return false. So that's why we are not executing these statements. This is logical end operator. Right. So what is the condition? J greater than 0. 1 greater than 0. Logical end of E of J minus 1. J. What is J value? 1 minus 1. E of 0. Greater than temp. So temp value is 2. Temp value is 2. So what is E of 0? 6. 6 greater than 2. 1 greater than 0, condition true. 6 greater than 2, condition true. Both are true, it will return true. So that's why we are executing these statements. E of J, E of 1 is equal to E of J minus 1. 1 minus 1. So E of 0. Now E of 1 value becomes E of 0. What is E of 0? 6. So E of 1 value becomes 6. Fine. Then after completion of this statement execution, then set J is equal to J minus 1. J is equal to J minus 1. 1 minus 1. That is 0. Right? So after completion of this execution, again we are checking the condition. Now what is the value of J? 0. So 0 greater than. So here E of 1 value becomes 6. F 1 is equal to 6. So here E of 1 is equal to 6. Right. So we are checking the condition 0 greater than 0. 0 greater than 0. Condition is false. So that's why we need not to check another condition. Why? Because any one of the false, it will return false. So that's why we are not executing these statements. Right? So after completion of this this looping, then E of J is said to be 10. What is E of J? E of 0 is said to be 10. Temp is equal to 2. Right? So now array becomes like this. 0, 1, 2, 3. So, E of 0 value is 2, E of 1 value is 6, E of 2, E of 3 is 7, 1, right? So, again, so after completion of entire operation, again, I is incremented by 1, not. Now, what is the value of I? I is equal to 2, I is equal to 2, 2 less than 4. Condition is true. Then we are entering into these statements. Temp is equal to E of 2. What is E of 2? Temp is equal to E of 2 is, temp is E of 2 is 7. Temp is equal to 7. Temp is equal to 7. J is said to be I. J is equal to I. What is I value? 2. Right? Then we are checking this loop. Why? J greater than 0, 2 greater than 0, logical end of E of J minus 1. E of J minus 1 means 2 minus 1, E of 1. So what is E of 1 value? 6. 6 greater than 10. 6 greater than 7. Right? So this is true. 6 greater than 7 is false. So that's why we are not executing these statements. Right? So after completion of this loop, then E of J is said to be 10. So E of 2 is said to be 7. E of 2 is said to be 7. Right? Now array becomes 2, 6. So what is E of 2 value? 7, 1. 0, 1, 2, 3. Fine? So after completion of entire execution, I is incremented by 1, right? Now what is the value of I? I is equal to 3, 3 less than 4. Condition is true. Then we have set these values. Temp is equal to E of I. E of I means, what is I value? E of I is E of 3. What is E of 3? 1. Now temp value becomes 1. J is equal to I. J is equal to I. J is equal to 3. After setting these values, then we are checking the condition. J greater than 0. J greater than 0. What is J value? 0. Sorry. 3 greater than 0. 3 greater than 0. Sorry. So here I am writing. Now what is the value of J? J is equal to three. Oh, here I am checking the condition. Na, 3 greater than 0. 3 greater than 0. Logical end of E of J minus 1. 3 minus 1. So 3 minus 1 means E of 2. What is E of 2 value? 7. 7 greater than temp. What is temp value? 1. E of J minus 1. 3 minus 1. 2. E of 2. 7 greater than. What is temp value? 1. So this is true. 3 greater than 0, 7 greater than 7 greater than 1. Both are true, then we are executing these statements. E of J. What is E of J? E of 3. E of 3 is equal to E of J minus 1. 3 minus 1. That is E of 2. What is E of 2 value? 7. Now E of 3 value becomes 7. Right? So, E of 3 is equal to 7. Then, J is equal to J minus 1. J is equal to, what is J value? 3 minus 1. That is, J is equal to 2. Fine. So, here, E of 3 position is occupied by, E of 3 position is occupied by 0, 1, 2, 3. E of 3 position is occupied by 7. Alright. So, after completion of this one, again, we are checking the condition. Right, J greater than 0. What is J value? 2. 2 greater than 0. Logical end of E of J minus 1. 2 minus 1. E of 1. What is E of 1 value? 6 greater than 10. 10 value is 1. Both are true. Then we are executing these statements. E of J. What is J value? 2. 2 minus 1. E of 1. What is E of 1 value? What is E of 1? 6. Then J is equal to J minus 1. J is equal to J minus 1. 2 minus 1, which is said to be 1. Now, second position is occupied by 6. So, after completion of this iteration, again we are checking the condition. Right? So, J greater than 0. 1 greater than 0. Logical end of E of J minus 1. 1 minus 1, E of 0. What is E of 0 value? 2 greater than temp. Temp is equal to 1. Both are true. Then we are executing these statements. E of J. What is E of J? E of 1 is equal to 1 minus 1, E of 0. What is E of 0 value? 2. Then J is equal to J minus 1. J is equal to J minus 1. 1 minus 1, 0. Right, now E of 1 position is occupied by 2. E of 1 position is occupied by 2. J is equal to 0. So, after completion of this one, again we are checking the condition. 0 greater than 0. This is false. So, that's why there is no need to check this condition. Why? Because any one of the false, it will return false. So, that's why we are not executing these statements. Right? So, after completion of this condition failure, then the control will be passed to this statement. Right? So, E of J, E of 0 is equal to temp. What is temp value? 1. Now, E of 0 position is occupied by 1. Right? So, here, after completion of this operation, the control will be passed to this one. Right? Now, I is incremented by 1. Now, what is the value of I? I is equal to 4. 4 less than 4. Condition is failure. So, that's why the control will be passed from out of the entire procedure. Right? So, after completion of entire operation, we can get the sorted array. So, sorted array is 1, 2, 6, 7. Oh, this is the simple logic for selection, sir. If you have any doubts regarding to this example, please post your comments in comment box. Thank you.